Hey, yo, together, and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays today with a TVC on the good old map, King Sejong Station Letter Edition. Oh, yeah. And here we are, loaded in, spawning in the top left position, playing for himself as the Red Zerg. It is Barcode! With lots of L's. And he's playing against me, the blue Terran spawning in the bottom right position, playing for Pro Kings, it is Alex Sashin. So this TVC is considered to be a good one. So let's see what happens. For our Barcode Zerg, he is going Hatchery. Okay. Hatchery is really good. You can go hatch gas pool or hatch hatch hatch, but that's really ballsy. So I think it will be hatch pool gas, as he's banking up a lot of minerals. So as a Zerg player, you can get the gas before the pool, it's fine. Or you get it afterwards, or you skip it and go for a greedy third as well. Or you get it and go for a greedy third as well. It's all possible. But we will see what he's doing. For me, it's just Rex, gas, Reaper, command center, standard opening, and potentially, it goes into double medevac drop with stim timing. That can work as well. So, yeah, let's see. Pool finishes up. That's the thing, now he needs to wait quite some time before speed can start. If you go gas pool, then you can fire up speed almost immediately after the pool finishes. That's the difference. This Reaper so far not scouting, because sometimes when I scout with the Reaper and I don't go SCV scout, then my opponent goes for 6 circlings, maybe even speed links, and gets the cancel on command center. So with the Reaper I am safe against most of it, and I will send it out right now to scout. So because now the command center should finish, the timing is gone, so that's fine. And there's the factory on the way. Whoopsie. Wow. Okay. Speed on the way, and speed takes almost 1.5 minutes, so 79 seconds. And he did start it around 2:20. That's okay. So I get some kills here, at least one so far. Maybe I can get the second circling. No, not gonna happen. I did scout the hatch. Oh, maybe I do. No, not paying attention, going for the watchtower instead. And yeah, behind that we have the stim timing, the starport. So standard opening, the Overlord is in position to spot it. This circling. Attack command, okay. And a Roach Warn, okay, it's not a super early Roach Warn. Will he get the kill? No. It's not a super early Roach Warn, it's more of a safety Roach Warn. Or maybe that's his tech choice. I think you can skip speedlings if you go for Roach Ravager, but we will see. He's planting creep, so he wants to go to the left side as well. The Reaper sneaks in, sees the Roach Warren, that's good. And behind, the wall is going up, playing like Trump. And yeah, double medevac production with a lot of marines. Some Zerglings attacking the rocks. Nice. So the medevacs will be out soon. Going for the third barracks before the command center. So that's not really how you should play it. I think you should just go for the third command center, go gas double e-bay and plant down three barracks later to go on 5 in total, and as soon as the third base is landed and halfway saturated, plant 3 more barracks to go on 8, get the second starport against Ultralisk or Mutalisk for the Liberator, and be safe. or the second factory if you're playing against Roach Ravager. So that's the, you can also go Bio Liberator against Roach Ravager, but I think tanks, tank evacs are the better option. So here's the drop. Should normally hit at 5 minutes. I did not really hit the timing. But maybe I can kill a queen or two. We will see. Stim finishes up right now. I kill some circlings and then back up. So the most important part is don't lose too many units. I shouldn't have even lost those 3 marines. It's bad damage because it should. You should use all your units together with the upcoming push. But what I'm doing is I'm getting a Viking normally to kill overlords for the drops to make it easier for me to drop. And going back again. So far I didn't do any damage. Not really. But it's fine. There's a drop coming in right now. And maybe I get a queen. Could be the case here. Or maybe a drone. So far, that's not the case. But here, that's what I was searching for. Dealing some damage. Getting 2 queens. Loading up. Boosting away. For 2 marines, losing 2 queens. Killing 2 queens. That's good for me. And here we see the Roach Ravager army composition. A Spinecrawler to be safe. Clearing the creep, also very important. And I was lucky to get the active creep to me here. So that resets the creep count almost immediately. Totally. Completely. But yeah, Lair is finished. We do have only 1 Evo Chamber. That's a big issue, so his upgrades won't be the best. Well, I got double eBay, the timing is off, and I went for 5 racks before the 3rd command center, and I don't think that that's a good thing to do here. I'm also trading very poorly here. I killed a Ravager, which is nice, but that's it. And uh-oh, don't lose the medivacs. Losing almost all those marines. I didn't pay attention. And the queen could kill the medevac? No. Turns around, no creep spread. I think that's a smart decision. Restarting the creep on the left side as well. There's an Ursadoc cough. Not looking nice. I don't like it. So, there you know. I do like the Ursadons more than the Ursadocs. I think there's a difference. The Leotes are really nice, and the Clinobots, the Automatons, they are awesome. But yeah, going for the Changeling on the Watchtower, that's nice. Also on the potential 4th base. And going for the Infestation Pit. So we might see a quite early Hive Tag out of our Barcode. And you can see in the Army Count and the Worker Count, it's not looking too bad. So Worker Count is equal, which is not good. He should be ahead quite a bit. Oh, he might get a Viking! Yeah, should get it. Oh no, it survives! So close. 5 HP. But he's really good in with his army supply. And he's ready to pounce. He sees the unload. I'm boosting here for no reason. I'm not scanning, so maybe I don't have enough energy. And I need to pick up and leave again. Losing Marines for nothing. And the Viking gets cleared as well. And really nice creep spread on the left hand side. Will I find any damage here? That's the big question. I'm scanning to get some creep. But was it worth it? I would say no. Behind the 2-2 on the way. Still, double Evo Chamber now. But he's only researching out of 1. And not going for Hive as well currently. He needs more gas. I need to pick up and leave, pick up and leave, pick up and leave! There we go. Yeah, he got 6 gas economy, more spine crawler, which is okay in his position. Finally going for the Hive Tech and a Spire. Could be for Corruptor or later on Bootlords as well. And I'm just starting now my 4th base, but, and that's the funny thing, it's earlier than his 4th, which is a big issue. I think he's way too passive. Will I find any damage here? I can kill a gas geyser. An extractor. That's not bad. Oh, and I can potentially kill the 4th base here. Will I do this? Maybe. I could get a queen. No, I boost out of here. That's bad. Clearing the creep, that's important. Getting all the tumors. The active ones. Do we drop again here? No, currently not, but this is a cancelled hatch. And he's still busy defending here, so I'm doing a good job of keeping my opponent on his back foot, but I'm heavily supply capped, and that's not good. Losing a medivac, also not good. Nice catch here, and clear killing. Oh no, close. Yeah, but it's not looking too good here. I'm pouncing on the right side, but this force is so small. You can see an army supply, only 4 tanks and that few units. That's not looking good. Sure, I can clear this army. That's nice. He's sandwiching me. At least he tries. And I'm fighting away from the tanks, which is not good. There we go. And I won't be able to save the bio. Maybe the tanks for some additional damage, which is fine. Oh yeah, that's a good position. So if you didn't know, tank evacs should get removed with the balance patch, which should, if I'm not mistaken, happen after BlizzCon. But tanks get a nice buff. They deal then 40 damage and in siege mode and 70 damage in siege mode versus armored, so that's huge. And the Ravager will get the armor tag for now, as it's looking, so Ravager won't counter tanks anymore. Not really, at least if you move into for the Corrosive Bile, you will lose most likely more Ravager than you could tanks, so that's good. Still heavily supply cap. No, not really, my production is bad. Going for 2 more starports, Ghost Academy and the Fusion Core. So making myself ready for the switch to the counter of Ultralisk, which might not even happen. So far, yes, the Hive is done. Oh, there's a tank. Poor little guy. And the fourth base gets cancelled again. No, killed. In this case, it's killed. And this position, I don't think Barcode can take this fight. I don't think he can. Good splits avoiding the corrosive piles, fighting at the tanks, but they are vulnerable, so maybe he can get a good fight. It's 2-2 against 2-2, and he's just outmassing me. So I need to retreat back here. Corruptor are killing the medivacs, and oh, there are 2 tanks up here, and the planetary. I don't think he can break this now. He could try to brute force it, and it might work against a small force, but it is indeed risky. Definitely need to repair the medivac. 3-3 and plus 2 on the way for him. Still just using 1 Evo Chamber. There's the second one using. Now he's going for the plus 1 at flyer attack. Getting more queens. He's only on 4 now. And that drop won't find any damage. It would be amazing if I would kill the queen, but that's not gonna happen. But I'm ahead in worker. You see, in the income I'm also ahead. The barcode not doing too good here. I might want to grab a 5th base soon. And he should go for some hive tech. He got the hive tech, but no hive tech units. So that's bad. No Viper, no Broodlords, no Ultralisk, nothing. And that's the big issue. Okay, he could maybe go for it now. He has the money. So both players are markering up. Barcode going for the second spire, so I think we will see Broodlords, and that's smart. Broodlords are not bad, but I have 3 starports, so 5 Viking production is a potential, is a possibility here. And I'm moving out. There's the Liberator. Good scan clears some of the creep, and now he knows I'm attacking here. I'm still not maxed out, but I got 3-3 on the way. Almost done. It hits a little bit before. Good Biles killing 1 tank, but that's a position he should not fight in. Not at all. Under the liberation zones against 3-3 bio with medivacs, that's not looking good here. And he's losing hard. That could be game. I can just push out and straight up win, potentially. So fun. Liberators chasing Corruptor, this should never happen. Yeah, that push could be enough to straight up kill him. I'm taking a fifth base, which was my floated orbital command from the main base, clearing more and more creep, and that position is looking not too bad here. He's moving in. There are the corrosive piles. Killing a lot of the tanks actually, which is really good, but he's fighting in a concave. Ravagers alone are not cutting it, and that's possibly it. He can't hold on. I don't see him holding on to this. Great job, sucker, fucker, I don't know. Bad swearing words, and there we have it. GG. I think his fourth base was too late, and he never went to Hive Tech. Was a big issue. He should have been more active. Other than that, and maybe take the chance and crush this base. It would have been expensive, but I think that would have been a very big blow to my economy and worth it. So, well, but other than that, nice game. Okay, guys, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and